When I picture a wasp, I think of something like this. This is the intimidating stare of a bald-faced hornet. And I'd be lying if I said I wasn't a little nervous filming this one up close and in flight. This wasp lives in a colony and defends its nest with a venom-injecting stinger. But social wasps like this represent less than 1% of all wasp species. As I found out filming the rest of the insects in this video, most of them are creatures that live vastly different lives. Most species of wasp, like this Braconid, are solitary parasites. Most of them qualify as parasitoids because they use their thread-like ovipositors to lay eggs in or on a host, usually another insect. The eggs hatch and the wasp larvae feed off of and eventually kill their hosts as they develop into adults. Here's what that can look like. This is a tobacco hornworm moth caterpillar feeding on a tomato plant. Those white things sticking up on its back aren't eggs, they're cocoons. Wasp larvae that have been living inside and feeding off of the caterpillar burrowed out of its body and spun these silk cocoons. The wasps spend their pupal stage like this, attached to the caterpillar until they're ready to emerge as adults. If you watch here, you can see the emerging wasp cut a circular cap off the top of the cocoon and come out head first and ready to fly. Here are adults of that species in flight. They belong to the Braconid genus Cotesia, which has over 70 species, all of which specialize on infecting butterfly and moth caterpillars. Speaking of caterpillars, these plant-feeding creatures aren't butterflies or moths, they're larval sawflies. Here are the adults. Sawflies are the most ancestral group in the ant, bee, and wasp order. In other words, every wasp, bee, and ant evolved from a sawfly-like ancestor. They mostly feed off of and develop on plant tissues. And you can tell sawflies from wasps because sawflies don't have a narrow, constricted waist between their abdomen and thorax. This sawfly belongs to a group known as the wood wasp. Here on the left, you can see the lack of a constricted waist really well. These adults deposit their eggs into dying or unhealthy trees. The larvae bore into the wood where they feed, mature, and if they're lucky, emerge as adults. One thing in the way of that process is this, an Aulacid wasp. If you look right here, you can see how this one has its ovipositor drilling down into the wood of a recently fallen maple tree. These wasps specialize in injecting their eggs into the larvae of wood-borne insects, and they go after two types. Larval wood wasps, like the one you saw right before this, or wood-boring beetle larvae. These are somewhat uncommon wasps, with about 200 species described in their taxonomic family. But the key to finding them is finding a recently felled tree that wood-boring beetles and sawflies have already began to populate with their young. In all these flight sequences, you may have noticed that while there are distinct front and hind wings, they're coupled together and flapping as a single unit. That's because the structure is here in the leading edge of the hindwing called hamuli. Hamuli are a series of hooks that attach and hold onto a section of the forewings. All ants, bees, and wasps have these structures, and the ones you're seeing here are on the wings of this, a wasp belonging to the largest family of wasps, the Ichneumonids. There are an estimated 60 to 100,000 different species of Ichneumonids. This one, in the genus Acrotaphus, is an ectoparasitoid of spiders. On the left, you can see a young Acrotaphus larva attached to the abdomen of an orb weaver spider. And on the right, an older and way larger larva still feeding. Here's another spectacular ichneumonid. This one, in the genus Trogus, specializes on swallowtail butterflies. They lay an egg in a young butterfly caterpillar and remain inside until its pupal stage. Instead of a butterfly emerging from a chrysalis, one of these, in this adult form, chews its way out, ready to go off, mate, and find another caterpillar to parasitize. So those wasps in flight are only a tiny representation of what wasps are. For instance, there are several groups that are completely wingless. The last clips I want to show you are of a wingless wasp I filmed over a year ago. It does something amazing, and I'll probably never have the chance to film it again. This is a tiny wingless parasitoid wasp in the genus Lelaps. Although I collected this one from the leaf litter in my own backyard, they're rarely encountered. So much so that this specimen is now one of only a handful we have in the state insect collection of North Carolina. Here's what it can do. These two sequences were captured at 40,000 frames per second. What they show is this wasp is using its middle legs to power an explosive jump. It only takes 2.6 milliseconds for it to get off the ground, and it accelerates at about 215 meters per second squared, which is around what a leafhopper can do. Parasitoid wasps like this are special because they're the only insects that use their middle legs to produce high-powered jumps like these. So wasps are pretty incredible, right? I hope your view about what wasps are has changed a little bit. I know mine has after making this and filming all those species. Thanks for watching.